Okay.
Hello.
Okay, hello everyone.
Hello everyone.
I don't know who this person is sitting next to.
I've never seen him.
He walked into my house.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. Last night, like, Mom was in my dreams the whole night. Like, and Caroline said, what did she do? And I said, she was just there, like, in different ages, and she, like, was, you know, giving me hugs, and you know how she used to grab our faces,
yeah.
Grabbing my face.
Yeah.
It was very comforting. Caroline,
did she grab your face too?
Yeah.
See, I thought it was just me.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought it was just my face.
She kind of had a thing for both our faces.
I guess.
Okay. Well, let's have a cheers.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Here's cheers to Suzanne, also known as Zanny.
Yes.
Yes.
To our matriarch.
Right. Mm-hmm. Great.
Yeah. I hope you guys all had a Merry Christmas.
It was a Merry Christmas.
Yeah. Tell us about, Alan was down with here with Leslie and Daisy. We spent Christmas with my family, so we were in Los Angeles. But we want to hear all about your Christmas.
Alan was so happy that he spilled on himself here, so we're hiding that now.
You're hiding it or you're pointing it out? You
no, don't notice this right here.
Why would he do that? What came over here?
Is this Huevos Rancheros from Christmas? Or is it latke juice?
Yeah, right. It could be both. Okay, so I have a little, I didn't notice it. Where is it?
I had it folded over.
Here it is,
folded
right here.
It over.
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
I'm going to go get your Suzanne spot remover and get rid of it.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, okay. Demo.
Or did someone sneeze on you?
It wouldn't be someone. You know what I don't understand?
Hmm.
So I use handkerchiefs.
Right.
Okay? I've always had handkerchiefs all my life. And about every 2 years, I order 16 Irish linen handkerchiefs.
Okay.
I don't know why I do that, because handkerchiefs never wear out. You know, you just keep washing them. So one day I'm using my handkerchief, and Suzanne said, old guys use handkerchiefs.
Okay, well, interesting. You should
no, no, just a moment.
Okay,
just
you finish,
a
you okay. finish.
You know what young guys do when they sneeze? They sneeze into their sweaters. They go,
Having a handkerchief to sneeze into is a good usage of it.
And there's also an art to using a folded handkerchief.
Yes.
So you don't use the same little patch a second time.
Right.
I'll be happy to show you how to do that, okay? I'm a master at that.
Okay.
I'll even supply you with some handkerchiefs.
Used ones?
You want used ones?
No.
I've got used ones. Yeah,
Bruce,
if
Bruce
you're into
that.
Bruce is
a single-use disposable kind of guy.
So like using your handkerchief at the dinner table, is that okay?
Well, what I usually do is, it depends who's there for dinner. If it's just the family,
mm-hmm.
I don't have a problem with that. I take out the handkerchief and I wave it around and then I go again.
And then do you say, how's the steak?
But if it's not the family, then I usually go into another room and where I can really go for it.
Right,
okay,
exactly.
Just like a major, major nose blow.
Right.
Okay. So I went to sleep last night, and because we are, what is the date today? The 27th.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So shortly it'll be January, and in January in 1959, I happened to be in Havana. When Castro came in with his people, and it was quite an experience to stand at the entrance of the Riviera Hotel, which was on the Malecón, which is like right on the water, beautiful white hotel, built by Meyer Lansky, who was a great builder. You probably know him as a great architect and builder, but you know, we know him as something else. Mm-hmm. Anyway, standing at the door, and all these guys with beards rushed in and they started smashing the tables and the slot machines and everything. And I'm thinking, you guys are nuts. How else are you going to make money? If you can't make money with your casinos, with tourism, because Cubans were not allowed to play in the casinos. How are you going to make money? So I don't know what they did. They must have replaced them because they have tourism today in Havana. And so they must have had to.
Do they have casinos though?
Yeah.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But Cubans can't go to them. It's only.
How come? Is it a communist rule or something?
I don't know. Oh. I don't know. I don't think there. I mean, there are rich people in Havana who I think are connected to the elites. Okay.
Right.
Like here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So maybe they can go. I don't know. But it was incredible. Havana was this incredible place. I was there the year before, in '58 as well, and I actually got to meet Meyer Lansky. I didn't know who he was because I was a kid, and I was introduced to him, and he made everything wonderful for me in the Riviera Hotel. I was there with an auto editor from the Boston Globe, who knew Meyer Lansky, and he introduced me.
An auto editor or audio? Did you say audio or auto?
No, a car.
Got it. Okay.
Like a car editor. What do you call him?
Someone who writes reviews about cars and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
That's why I was there, because it was the Chrysler new car show in Miami at the Americana Hotel. And so we had some time off, and he invited me to go to Havana. That's when I met Meyer Lansky. I didn't know who he was. And I actually saw him about 6 months later. He asked me to call him if I ever came to Miami, which I did. And we went for a walk with his little, he had a little dog, went for a walk with his little dog.
He was just misunderstood.
Exactly. And there was this car, shiny black automobile with darkened windows that was following us as we were walking with the little dog. And I said, Meyer, there's a car following us. And he said, oh yeah, they work for me. They were probably guards, I would guess.
For sure.
Okay. But again, I was a kid. I didn't know.
Wow. Right?
So, but Havana, I loved Havana so much when I was there in '58 that I applied at the TV network for a job, because they did 2 hours of English language programming every day. I think it was called Sebaku, something like that. And the manager of the station said, we'd be happy to have you. You're an experienced broadcaster. And you sound good. The problem is that you must be a Cuban citizen, because the TV network is financed by the Cuban government. And I wasn't ready to change citizenship at that point. But I'll tell you, Cuba was a wonderful place. I drove across Cuba, and I stopped in Oriente Province, which is right in the middle of Cuba. And there's a big city there called Santa Clara. And I happen to know a woman who's a nurse here in town who was born there. And it's too bad that the country all crashed and all those promises never came true. It's too bad, really, because Havana, the architecture in Havana, most of the buildings were put there by the conquistadors, the Spanish. It's beautiful, beautiful architecture, and wide streets, and there's a place called the Prada, which is a raised sidewalk right next to a road where people go walking every night after they close the shops. So it was wonderful. And Havana is unlike any other Caribbean country that I've been to, unlike the Bahamas or Jamaica or Trinidad or Tobago. It's totally different, and it's too bad. I don't know what's happening there today, but for a lot of people, it can't be good. So I've just finished my pitch on Havana.
Well, interestingly, continuing on with Havana, Caroline and I have a really dear friend who's the grandson of the president of Cuba before Batista.
Before Batista?
Yeah, Menoncel. His name is Pedro Menoncel. And people always mistakenly call him Pablo, and it bugs the crap out of him. So now, of course, we call him Pablo.
Of course. he lives in California?
He lives in Miami.
Oh.
But his grandfather was friends with, who's my favorite writer? Ernest Hemingway.
Oh, yeah.
Ernest Hemingway. And he has letters from Hemingway to his grandfather.
Well, I've been to Hemingway's house.
Oh, really? In Cuba?
In Cuba.
Okay.
It was in a place called Varadero. I think Varadero Beach or Varadero. And it was an interesting experience to walk into that house and know that Hemingway was sitting there writing.
Yeah.
And drinking.
Yeah, right? He was very disciplined. And he wrote 500 words a day, and if he was going fishing or hunting or something, the next day he'd write 1,000 words today so that he could take tomorrow off.
Wow.
Very disciplined.
Hmm. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Well, they sat there having a little 30-year-old rum.
Exactly.
Guys.
Yeah.
I have an announcement.
What is that?
I'm feeling something in my gut.
Okay.
It's kind of a big announcement.
Okay.
We have a huge free gift today.
We have what?
A huge free gift. Today.
A huge free
it
gift.
It is. It
that
is
means
a big free
Al's
gift.
Al's giving away crap today.
Yes. Yes. Alan doesn't even know about this.
Exactly.
Okay, so here's the
you
deal.
Giving away the farm, Al?
I have,
every day.
I have three surprises for you today, Alan. Number one, if you buy anything at SuzanneSummers.com for $49.99, you get this for free.
What?
Wow.
Free, this is a 10-serving bag of original Gut Renew, which, come on, everyone wants right now because we want to get rid of that holiday bloat. It's 10 servings. It is the original flavor. It's our superfood protein formula. It has 20 grams of organic plant-based protein, plus all those incredible gut health nutrients. It has zero sugars. It's just awesome. This, just so you know,
anything?
$50. You spend $50.
Oh, okay.
And you get this as a free gift. So you don't need a promo code. When you put something in your cart that is worth $49.99 or more, you'll see a little pop-up and it will say, do you want this free gift? And you're gonna say yes. Now, what you need to know about this free gift is that this has a best buy date on it. And the best buy date of the free gift is 4/24. The ones that you'll be getting, it's 4/24. So that doesn't mean that it expires on 4/24. It means it's optimal if used by 4/24. Slowly, the potency of the ingredients start to decline. But here's the good news for you. This will be a free gift until we run out of this excess inventory.
Wow.
So it's only while supplies last. Get it while you can. That is our free gift today.
And this is all I've had today.
It is.
It's a meal.
Wow.
I had this around.
Me too.
Yeah.
That's all I had today.
Yeah. Well,
I just remembered that.
Yeah.
Well, I'm making you something very delicious for dinner.
What is that?
I brought you some Christmas duck confit.
Yeah.
I love your duck confit.
Yeah. With a sour cherry port sauce.
Wow.
And
cherry anything.
Sour cherry port sauce and the duck fat potato chips.
I love duck fat potato chips. Wow.
Yeah.
Duck confit, does that mean duck with feet?
No.
No? Okay.
Confit means cooked in its own fat.
Okay, so I'd like you to make a sentence of these words. The duck defense.
The duck defense?
Defense is one
the
word.
Duck defense. DeBille? What?
Did you say DeBille?
Mm-hmm.
That's not a word.
It's not? Hold it.
Unless you're talking of Bill.
He's got a joke. He's brewing. Just give him a minute.
Okay, but he asked me to make a sense of it, so I want to make sure I know the rules.
DeBille? It's a word now.
A bill.
Yeah, detail. Okay.
Detail.
Okay.
Deduct,
defense, the bill, and detail.
The duck or deduct?
He's just changing
deduct.
It to
what? Deduct?
Deduct.
Okay. If you deduct.
You're never going to get it.
The bill?
No, you're not going to get it. No. Here's the sentence.
All right.
The duck jumped over the fence, and the bill went in front of the... What was the last word? I was 15 years old last time I had this.
You need to like do the
duck jumped over
Carson face. Yeah. You need to sell the bomb.
Right. The duck jumped over the fence and, oh, I know.
Okay.
Defeat. Went before detail.
Okay.
The duck jumped over the fence and defeat went before detail.
Okay. Should we tell your dad's potato joke?
Sure.
I told you about Tony's joke about two guys are on the beach.
Tony had the greatest jokes.
Yeah.
And he acted them out. He, with Maria, who was in the hospital, and she didn't want the hospital guy to shave her. But the way Tony tells it, it's hysterical. I won't even try to tell it, okay? Because Tony was Italian. He did it with an Italian accent. And so when he decided to do Maria shaving for her surgery, and he actually asked Maria to do this. Maria, are you doing it?
So
anyway, yeah.
Two guys on the beach, and one guy, it's like, he's attracting all the ladies. He's, you know, walking on the beach, and he's just getting numbers left and right. And the other guy isn't attracting anyone. So he sees the guy and he says, hey, how are you getting all these ladies? I mean, what's your secret? He goes, get yourself a potato and put it in your bathing suit. And he goes, okay. So the next day, the guy's walking down the beach with his potato. Not one woman is attracted to him. Not one woman's coming up. And he walks over to the guy from yesterday and he's like, hey, I got the potato and I put it in my bathing suit. No one's coming up to me. And the guy goes, put the potato in the front.
You guys, I have another surprise for you.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm still recovering from the last surprise.
Well, Alan.
Yep.
I promised you last time I would bring you
what?
A bottle of the new Growback Shield and Shine.
Wow.
This is the new heat protecting styling product that has been vastly upgraded from the former product that everyone loved. It's for your hair.
But you use it the same way though, right?
Yeah.
Take the thing and...
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Wow.
It's like the... You remember the True Brazilian Activating Serum?
Yeah.
This is the upgrade.
Oh, wow.
So it has the Growback ingredients in it. It has new heat protector. So it's a very good styling product. You can zhuzh your hair with it.
So I can, is this like styling gel as well?
Yeah, it is a styling serum.
Wow.
It is okay. A styling serum.
Oh, have we started selling this yet?
Yes, you can use it right now. You can put it in your palms and just clean up your hair a little.
Well,
not that it looks like you just got up from a nap.
Yeah, what do you mean clean up my hair?
You know,
what are you saying there, Caroline?
On air presentation.
This is nap hair.
Yeah.
Okay? It looks good.
Yeah.
Nap hair. Okay.
Okay. Ooh.
The Growback, the hair and scalp formula is actually arrived at the warehouse and we're just loading it in. So that should be ready
nice.
In a couple days. Yeah, get the sides. Here we go. Yep.
Oh my God, yeah. I feel so beautiful all
this
of a sudden.
This side, you need to just smooth back a little. Yep. Yeah.
Do a little zhuzh of that.
You're telling me what to do with my hair?
I have a lot of hair too. I have a lot of hair too.
I'm going to get you a towelette for your hands.
It's okay. I have some tissues here. Remember we used to call it Kleenex? Tissues. It's the tissues. It's like on airplanes, no more stewardess. Flight attendants.
Well, Kleenex would like you to call it Kleenex.
They would. You know, I used to work at the Indy 500 every year. on the end of May.
Right, Memorial Day.
Memorial Day.
Those were like the A.J. Foyt years?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there was one guy who, I think he, I don't know if he sponsored a car or if he just loved coming to Indy 500, but his name was Jim Kimberly. Mm. And he was one of the heirs to the Kimberly Clark fortune,
right. Which owns Kleenex.
This guy.
Yeah.
Okay. And he was the first man I ever knew who had a punctured earlobe with a gold ring. Okay?
Wow.
Think about it. In the 50s?
Yeah, right.
Early 60s?
Right.
And he always had a great suntan, handsome guy, and he always had a beautiful woman on either arm.
That's the potato.
Yeah.
You guys don't worry about that one annoying person on Instagram. I blocked that person.
Ah.
What happened?
She was bothering me. Just some annoying person on Instagram, so I blocked her.
Probably saying something awful about one of us or both of us. Or all of us.
Yeah, what did she say? I like to know what the haters are saying.
Well, I try not to talk about them, but then everyone talks about them. She just thinks it's... You two should use your own handles and not Suzanne's, and it's not...
Use our own what?
Handles on Instagram. He doesn't even know what that is.
Yeah.
It's inappropriate for you to be using Suzanne's handle.
Oh, okay,
And you guys should be grieving.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for telling me how to feel and how to grieve.
Wow.
I'm Irish. We grieve through tears and laughter.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
I love this.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you order that, you'd be on your way to getting the free gift today.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
How much is this?
I don't know.
Oh.
Wow.
I think it's $39.99.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Blue Fox to Red Eagle.
Well, whatever it costs,
it's worth it.
You know, the thing is, you can't lie about what stuff does. True. I know when you go online, they lie all the time, but those are people that don't care if they're arrested.
They're bots.
Pardon?
They're foreign bots.
Yeah, exactly. AI people.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But we do care, and we clear everything at great expense, okay? We have these high-priced lawyers who know everything about supplements and about chemicals and about stuff like this, and we don't put it up for sale until we get total clearance from these lawyers. And if they make a mistake, big trouble.
Yeah.
Which they've never made a mistake. In 40 years, they've never made a mistake.
Which is kind of a bummer, because I've been dying to tar and feather someone.
Tar and feather? How old are you?
I've never done it before.
Wow. There's probably a lot of stuff you've never done before.
Yes, but tar and feathering a lawyer?
Oh, a lawyer?
Right.
Oh, yeah.
You know, when they make a mistake?
Except there's one lawyer I would never do that with, and that's my great buddy, Bob.
Bob. Yeah.
Who's like...
We're all fans of Bob.
I remember, Suzanne used to at our office Christmas party every year. And in addition to the office, we would invite outside people who were, part of our organization in terms of operationally. And so we would invite everybody. And Suzanne would go from one person to the next person to the next person. And sometimes there'd be 50 people there. She would talk about who they are, how long they'd been with us, what they did, how great they are, and et cetera, et cetera. So she got to Bob, who's my favorite lawyer, and she said, Bob, and I'm not going to tell you his last name because I don't want him to get him in trouble. Bob is Alan's favorite lawyer. And what she forgot about was that there were two other lawyers there who we had worked with who were not Alan's favorite lawyers, okay?
You know what? The truth hurts sometimes.
I know.
You guys, the most exciting thing just happened.
What?
We just I'm talking this within the last 30 seconds, we put a brand new product at SuzanneSummers.com.
What?
It is. It is now for sale.
What?
What is that?
These are the brand new Gut Renew Fiber Gummies.
Oh, wow. Wow, what if I eat the
they
whole jar?
They are so tasty.
If you eat the whole jar, you better walk yourself in the room.
They come in
the room.
It comes in three flavors.
Well, let's try some right in our room.
So, strawberry, peach, and raspberry. Helps promote digestive health, helps support regularity because they are made with prebiotic fiber. One serving has 6 grams of fiber and zero sugars. They are so yummy. I mean, you're only supposed to eat, you can see the serving size is three gummies. So eat three of them per day. You're going to be so happy to eat three of these per day.
They're
delicious.
30.
I'm going to show you the ingredients so you can see.
Okay.
Water, pectin, citric acid, sodium citrate, vegetable oil, canuba wax, natural flavors, grape extract, and paprika for color.
And they're actually really nice gummies.
Yeah, they're delicious.
Wow.
Clean ingredients. We do not use any weird things in our natural flavor. Our natural flavor is just, it is peach flavoring, it is strawberry flavoring, it is raspberry flavoring.
The only weird is right here.
Yeah. No, this is not what Camellia was passing, what Violet was passing out at dinner. She was passing out digestive enzymes, which I always also highly recommend. Is this instead of Gut Renew? No, definitely not. You're going to get way more nutrients from Gut Renew. This is just a little fiber boost.
Yeah,
aren't they good? This is a great way to get to your free gift. Here, let me see these so I can show them up close. Okay, so these are the three. These are the three colors. This is
delicious.
Raspberry. This is peach, and this is strawberry. And they're so good. So just have three a day.
Oh, a day?
Yeah, per day.
You know what? I know I'm excessive. Okay, with everything. When it says take one, I take two. When it says take three, I take four or five. Okay. I can't help it. I was born in a boy.
He's not recommending you do that because our lawyers tell us to only.
You're a favorite lawyer.
Tell people to take the suggested serving.
Yeah,
amount.
But I don't work for this company, so I can tell you to take.
That's not true. That is not true. No.
Oh, it's true that I don't work for this company.
You don't even know.
It is true, but you're sitting in a chair during a show, so today.
Wow.
Yum.
Okay.
Yum.
I'm going to give some of these to Gloria tonight. Okay. What a night we'll have.
No, nope, well, I'm not recommending them for pets.
Meow.
Yum.
I know, we're having too much fun here.
There are people, that's right. We're supposed to be grieving.
I know.
The vegetable oil is coconut and palm. Those are the two oils in here, coconut and palm.
Oh, I've never used palm oil. Palm.
Palm comes from here.
Yeah. Whose palm are we using?
Yeah.
I'd sure like some more of that tequila back here, but
I can make that happen.
Can you?
Yeah.
So just like a couple of
rocks,
and then some. Michael gave me the most wonderful, beautiful bottle of tequila, and that's what we've been drinking.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what's great about the time between Christmas and New Year's? You can drink every day.
You don't know what day it is, and you don't know who
you
are.
Absolutely. And you don't care. Yeah, you don't care who you are.
That post-Christmas, I crash hard. But it was a wonderful, wonderful Christmas. If you came in late, we have a free gift with purchase. This is a free gift with any purchase of $49.99 or more. This free gift, the reason we're doing this is because we have a little extra inventory, and this is going to expire in April of 2024. So you have 4 months to use it. It doesn't go bad in April. It just has a stamped best buy date on it. So we don't sell it after that time, but believe me, if we don't go through it, that's what we'll be drinking every morning, because we have this every single morning. Violet makes it every single morning. Bruce makes it every morning. I have been a little off the wagon, but once Christmas ended, I started back. Alan, are you drinking this still every day or most days?
I had this morning.
Oh, what flavor did you have?
I haven't eaten today.
What flavor did you have today?
Cocoa.
Or?
What is it? Cocoa.
Cacao?
I think he had coconut.
Coconut, no. It was
Oh, cacao. You had
cacao.
The chocolate one.
Cacao.
Oh, cacao. I have that one here too.
I love chocolate.
When I get really angry.
It also comes in the chocolate, so you can buy the chocolate. The original is the one that is the free gift this time. But
sometimes.
This is a great way if you are wanting to, you know, it sounds cliche, but it is the time of the year when most of us are like, okay, put down the toffee, stop the, you know, the constant, rich, delicious, wonderful foods, and we try to do something. Just start your day with a smoothie. It's a way to kind of ease back in.
Caroline, can you explain why coconut oil and palm oil are actually good for you? Because people are asking questions about, they're confusing it with vegetable oil.
We don't like vegetable oil.
Well, the manufacturer on this put coconut and palm oil as vegetable oil, but there are the breakdown of what they're calling vegetable oil is from coconut and palm, which is really more of a fruit. But coconut and palm, you know, Suzanne has always talked about good, healthy fats from real foods, and that is always what she believed in. So she loved olive oil, she likes coconut oil, she likes palm. Those are all good.
Flax oil. Mm-hmm. But don't use canola, okay? Canola is an omega-6. We don't need any more omega-6s, okay? So don't use canola, and canola comes from a plant in Canada called the rapeseed plant.
Needs a rebranding.
Nice, yeah. Huh? And canola.
I guess that's what they tried
stands
to do with
for, canola. Can stands for Canada, and Ola stands for Mazola. Canola.
I didn't know that.
I just made it up.
You totally had me.
No, it's true.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's well, I guess true. They did try to do a rebrand on it, and they told us all it was the healthiest, best oil for us, but it is
omega-6. You don't want omega-6.
It's not. We usually, you know, Suzanne always used to say we don't have enough omega-3 and we have too much omega-6, and we're trying to do this. So anyway, this is a great way to get your fiber, and they're delicious. So
Linda Tonkinson is watching us from London right now. It must be very late in London.
It was like 9 hours difference.
Yeah.
Or six or
so like one
difference.
One in the morning?
Seven. Yeah, what's she doing right now? Because it's the middle of the night.
I don't know. I don't know if she's visiting there or she lives there and she's just
is she
up
by
late.
Herself?
Maybe she has jet lag.
Yeah.
Or maybe she has company.
I hope so.
Well, yeah. It's not that late. It's
like 1 a.m.
Yeah. Too bad.
Is that it? 1 a.m. in England?
1:36.
There'll always be a... You know, what is it? I used to know all those World War II British songs. There'll be something over the White Cliffs of Dover. There'll be bluebirds over the White Cliffs of Dover, right? Is that it?
Oh, I guess because of daylight savings time, it's only 12:36. So somebody just said it's 12:36.
Oh, okay.
So it's 8 hours.
So again, with the deal today, the retail price on these is $34.99. We sell this at a discount at $34.99. So if you buy this together, it would be like getting 2-for-1. But just get something else in your cart that gets you up to that $49.99. This is a smoking good deal, this free 10 servings. 10 servings of Gut Renew, and it is a good... It is a good time to clean out the holiday excess.
So I've been wearing my little love bracelet.
Oh, look.
Huh?
Caroline's hair looks amazing.
Thank you.
All caps.
I am 1 year into my grow back hair and scalp serum. And as soon as probably next week, I'll do a grow back show. Oh, that's so cute.
What do we call this?
Suzanne's love bracelet.
Yeah, I love this.
Well, it's appropriate.
Okay. And in addition to that, one of my great Christmas gifts this year, great Christmas gifts, was a chain. And it was a golden chain. And at the end of the golden chain, I'm going to show you what's there, okay? If I can find the chain, here we go. And here we go. And here's the chain that was given to me by these two people I'm with right now. And at the end of the golden chain, I have Suzanne's wedding ring.
Aww.
Okay. So sweet. And I find myself playing with it all day. It's so weird.
Isn't it? It's like, I don't know. I think certain things have energy.
Absolutely.
Like this was on her finger.
Yeah.
And she had 45 years. I mean, yeah.
She had little fingers.
Yeah, she had very small fingers.
Yeah, I can barely get it on my little mm-hmm. finger. Okay. But she's right here with me all the time. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Carrie AZ13. I'm crying. I'm not crying. You're crying.
I wear my dad's watch all the time. That's why I have this big mantle. This is my, and to me, like my dad's energy is in that. Watch. This was a gift from Suzanne. There's just something about it that yeah. just makes you feel like, I do think energy resides in things like that. Or we apply it because we need it for comfort.
And I wear a potato nice. Because of your dad.
You know what I have in the refrigerator? I have, what did he say?
He said he wears a potato.
It's working.
Yeah. But is it one of those big Idahos or one of those little
it's a
baby
little big, new potato? Yeah, right. It's a Yukon Gold.
Sweet.
I love these gummies. I have to stop myself from eating them because I'm treating them like it's a confection.
Exactly.
I know. But they really, I mean, they're tasty.
So
very tasty.
The good thing is I have no plans on leaving the house anytime soon. So if there's a, you know.
Remember when my cousin, when he was young,
oh yeah,
got up on the counter? And he found some chocolate, but he didn't realize it was chocolate X-Lax. And it scared the you-know-what out of him, literally.
Well, didn't one of his brothers, when he discovered that he ate the X-Lax, say...
one of the older brothers said...
You're going to blow your brains out.
Yes. Yeah.
Right?
And so that night, because he was like 7 years old, he was on the toilet crying. They were like, what's wrong? Don't worry. I mean, just like it'll go through you. And he said, but what about my brains?
Harmony is asking if she has her gut renew, plus she takes the prebiotic and the probiotic, is it too much to add the fiber gummy? The answer is no. They all are doing different things, actually. The prebiotic and the probiotic are helping to support your healthy gut flora. So they're helping you to get more good gut flora and less bad gut flora. The Gut Renew also has that amazing protein in it. Plus it has additional nutrients to help with your gut flora and to help shore up your gut lining. But none of those products actually have a lot of fiber in them. So the fiber you can certainly get from eating fruits and vegetables, and we hope you are getting plenty of fruits and vegetables, but the fiber gummy is a way to supplement your daily diet with a little extra fiber in a great tasting gummy.
And if you're helping your gut flora, isn't that helping your body do its own work? Like, once, if you can enhance your flora, then your body's working optimally.
Well, that's a very intelligent question.
Oh, well, thank you.
Well, yes. No, she was just asking if it's too much to add.
No, I understand.
Yeah.
So, but isn't the beauty of these products that it's helping your body work optimally?
It's helping to get your digestive system working at optimum, yes. Yeah. So, absolutely.
Well, we know what that means.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It means you're going to have a good, great poop every day.
What?
Yeah.
A religious experience,
yeah,
I refer to it as.
It should be easy and it should be consistent.
I mean, think about it, okay? It's always a little awkward talking about, you know, bodily functions, especially since it's dinner time in the East. So I won't specifically talk about
it. Try the Alfredo.
Okay. But I look at, you know, I look at stuff like this, okay, I think, okay, I know what this is good for, okay, because I don't like missing my religious experience every morning. Every single morning, I think, okay, it's time. The little bell goes off, and my body says, quickly, quickly, quickly. And then suddenly, this amazing...
Alan does a little dance on the way to the bathroom.
Yeah, it's amazing what happens, okay? It's beautiful. And that's why I'm sitting here today. I mean, normally I wouldn't be here today, okay? But I'm sitting here today, and it has to do with the fact that my bodily functions happen to be working really well.
That's amazing.
And I want to thank you, Caroline, and
for?
Bruce, okay?
For?
For my bodily functions.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah.
I did bring you Gut Renew, so yeah. If that's helping.
I appreciate that.
I do want to say that, again, if you came in, this is our free gift with purchase. So $49.99 purchased, you get a free bag. This is the 10-serving bag of the original formula Gut Renew. These free gifts that are coming to you, they are stamped optimal by 4/24. So that means that the optimal date is by April. This is not like milk. It doesn't go bad. It's not an expiration date. But it does give us a guideline of how long we would want to have this at our storage facility. So we won't continue selling this bag with that optimal buy date. But it doesn't go bad on that day. It just means best buy that day. So you know, anyway, you have 4 months to use it. It's 10 servings.
You know, I have supplements and I have HGH and I have testosterone. And I've talked to one of my great doctors about, so when it says... you know, throw it away after you use it, blah, blah, blah. And he said, it loses 1% of its potency every year. Okay? Now, that has to do with supplements and with HGH and testosterone. I don't know about this.
Gut Renew.
Yeah, it depends on the supplement. It depends on, you know, if it's a medication from your doctor, you would always check with your doctor because there's a reason people put expiration dates on things. But I can tell you with this particular product, with Gut Renew.
But you know, who makes the decision about dates, expiration?
Well, scientists. I will tell you, the manufacturer will often
people
give us...
People who study it.
Oh, you mean...
No, it's actually the manufacturer in these situations, they guarantee that it will be good until that date. So, I mean, for instance, I would have extended the expiration date on this because there's zero lack of quality. Nothing
yeah, right.
has degraded. Like, this is, I have these in my earthquake kit. Like, this is what,
yeah.
If we ever had an emergency, this is what we have in our emergency kit because you want to make sure you can get good nutrition and it's hard to get protein in those situations.
And I need serotonin at that point.
Is that your emergency kit?
We have Gut Renew in our emergency kit, yeah.
Absolutely,
wow.
Yeah. And the bars.
Yeah.
Well, my emergency kit?
Yeah.
Guns and ammo. Okay. Guns and ammo.
I find that...
And then you'll get all this stuff, all you need, Okay.
The ammo gets stuck in my teeth, though. You know, a lot of people always ask me, because I take, you know, everyone knows I take 200 supplements a day, plus I drink this. Now I'll start eating these. And people are like, why do you need that? You just eat organic food. And the sad irony of organic food is that even when it's organic, it's lost about 30% of its nutritional value compared to food grown without without any chemicals 60 or 70 years ago.
But that doesn't mean that we're not recommending organic food.
Totally. No. But like you need additional assistance with supplementation. That's why it's becoming more and more important as the earth and civilization evolves.
Well, you know, the same
Meta
thing.
Meta said, keep doing what you're doing, it's working. And you know, she also said over the holidays, she was using eggnog flavored almond milk in her Gut Renew.
Oh, yeah.
And creating an eggnog flavored Gut Renew smoothie. That's a great idea.
Yeah, I think with a little rum.
I was going to say, you know, during this period between Christmas and New Year's, all bets are off. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can have tequila.
Right.
Gut Renew.
Right.
Right?
Right.
I'd like another tequila. Would you mind getting me
another? Sure. How do you say Gut Renew in Spanish, Carolyn?
Gut Renew.
Yeah, there you go.
Gut Renew. Cha cha cha.
All right, you're on your own over there, Al.
Okay, I like my little love bracelet, okay, that a lot of you got. How did everyone get their bracelet, Carolyn?
Well, it was in the subscription box in October. But now we have them for sale.
You have what? So
it was in the subscription box for October.
Yeah.
And now we have them for sale. So if you didn't get a Suzanne Love bracelet, now I was able to get extras and now we have them on the website.
I love wearing this. It's great. I wore it in the shower yesterday. It was like a test, okay? The reason I wore it in the shower, I thought, if it gets wrecked, I can get another one. Okay? I know people.
You have an inside track.
Yeah, I can get another one, okay? It didn't get, nothing happened to it.
Remember the little diver you used to wear around your neck?
Yeah, it's packed in one of my boxes.
That was my whole childhood. You always had that diver. And didn't you have to cut it off for a commercial or something?
I did. I had to cut it off when I started working again.
Work.
Yeah, work. It's in the way of everything.
The fun. Although we're working and I'm having fun. So
no, that's actually the only sport I've really excelled in is scuba diving.
Uh-huh.
And I used to spend 6 weeks every year in Mexico. In Acapulco, and I got to know the two brothers who ran the, what do you call them, the water franchises, or?
Water franchises?
Well, they owned the scuba diving thing.
Oh, okay.
They owned the take you up in the speedboat and you're flying up in the air.
Oh, okay, so all the tourist activity.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So I got friendly with the Arnold brothers in Acapulco.
Sounds very Mexican.
Well, actually, their father was Swiss, their mother was Mexican.
Oh, okay.
So these were these two handsome guys. And I used to go diving every day for 6 weeks. And that little thing they gave me, the silver diver, was because I had dived to 200 feet.
Wow.
And when you're at 200 feet, it's not fun.
That sounds like it probably hurt your ears.
It feels like there's a Buick sitting on your chest.
Wow.
Okay. There's no color down there. I mean, I was wearing yellow shorts and they weren't yellow down below. There's no color down there. And you see strange little fish down there that are fearless. You can go up to them and pick one up. Bottom feeders. Actually, I've been a bottom feeder myself a couple of times. Okay.
But that's another story.
That's another, we won't tell that.
So how deep is, don't they call my pleasure, the shadow there, or the, like there's a depth at which now you're in darkness, which is what you're talking about.
Oh, I wasn't in darkness. I mean, it was still light down there. The sun when I looked up, I couldn't see the sun shining because I was 200 feet of water.
So it was dark.
Well, it wasn't dark. It was colorless.
Okay.
And it was hard to breathe. I was only down there for maybe 10 minutes.
That's a lot.
Yeah, it was a lot, but I wanted to prove, okay? Because there's a macho thing when you start diving down to 200 feet and you're with the Arnold brothers, okay? And one of them, I think, was taught the U.S. Navy Frogman program during World War II.
Wow.
And I think he used to free dive to 200 feet, and to prove he'd been down there, he'd bring up a bottom feeding fish, and then let it go. I've never done that.
Wow.
Yeah.
And did it hurt your ears?
No, because after a while, your eustachian tubes get used to it. Like when people who are just learning how to dive, they get to like 5 feet underwater, and their ears hurt.
Okay.
So you have to exercise your eustachian tubes by holding your nose and blowing inside, and you're blowing out your eustachian tubes, and they're doing this, in and out, in and out, in and out. And once you've been diving for a few weeks, you don't have to stop on the way down to decompress. Mm. You just go straight down. You fill your pockets with rocks, and you drop all the way down to the bottom.
But don't you have to come up slowly, or you get
rid
bends?
Of the rocks? Yeah, you don't come up fast. Only once I had a trouble, my oxygen tank stopped feeding me oxygen. And I thought, okay, this is not good. And I came up faster than I normally would have, thinking I may have to get into one of those tanks.
Decompression.
Yeah. But I didn't have to. And so I did spend a couple of years in a mental hospital after that.
I remember that.
Yeah, but it was fine.
He just got out.
Yeah, it was fine.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
He's fine. Every once in a while, it was a little awkward.
Yeah.
All right, you guys, we're going to just do a recap for those of you who came in late. We have a free gift with purchase. It is the 10-serving bag of Gut Renew in the original flavor. It has a Best Buy date of April 2024. You get this with any purchase of $49.99 or more at SuzanneSummers.com. You don't need a promo code. You'll get a little drop-down box when you have $49.99 in your cart, and it will say, hey, do you want this free gift? And that'll be yours at no charge. We are debuting for the very first time the Gut Renew Fiber Gummies. It's not in place of Gut Renew. This is just in our Gut Renew line. So this is a fiber gummy. You take three of these per day. They come in three great flavors, peach, strawberry, and raspberry. In those three gummies, you get 6 grams of fiber, which is great because it helps support a good poop. And who doesn't love that?
And everyone's read the book, Everybody Poops.
I was also giving Alan his own bottle of Growback Shield and Shine. This is our heat protectant serum. So this is a styling product. And this goes with our Growback hair and scalp treatment, which is the one that helps support healthy hair growth. That will be back in stock by next week, and we will do a show dedicated to Growback. I am 1 year into the process. It has given me back my healthy, thicker looking hair, and I'm thrilled about it. So we're gonna share that with you. But now it is time to make Alan his duck confit.
Yes.
And some duck fat potato chips and a sour cherry port sauce.
Oh, wow.
So if you wanna watch, that'll probably be on my story, but we're gonna have a great dinner.
Yep.
These guys are all sauced up.
So how do I make it on my story?
Well, you don't post anything.
And what's my story?
Yeah.
Well, you've had someone tried to pretend that they were you.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, yeah.
If Alan ever DM'd you, it was not Alan. It was an imposter. I believe that account has finally been taken down now. So just know, Alan, he doesn't comment.
He's not going to ask you for money.
He's never going to comment. He's never going to DM you. He's never going to post anything. That's how you know it's Alan.
If he asks for money, send it to me, and I'll donate it on your behalf.
Yeah, I was going to say, I might ask you for money. Okay? And if you think it's me, you can write that check.
Yeah, don't.
Yeah, he's being Soupy Sales right
there's
now.
There's some creepster out there.
You know, the Soupy Sales had a show in Detroit in the 50s on the ABC station there, WXYZ. And he had two shows. He did a noon show for kids. In those days, kids would go home for lunch every day. So he would do a noon show for kids. Then he would do the 11:30 show at night for adults. And it was exactly the same script, but the late night show was filthy. Okay. It was so weird. The same words, the same guy doing it, but the way he delivered the lines, I mean, it was actually brilliant the way he did it. One script, two different shows, okay?
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's revive it.
Is Soupy still around?
I think
Soupy passed.
Yeah?
Yeah. Soupy's in the Great Hall of Comedians now.
Oh. We're getting signs.
Yeah.
It's time.
Yeah.
Shut down. All we're right. At an hour. That was a fun show. Thanks,
okay,
everyone.
Okay, so thank you for joining us.
Happy New Year. You guys, we're back on Friday. Violet's going to do a glam New Year's Eve makeover. Ooh. For us on Friday. And it's going to be at 5 p.m. because she's just coming back from a trip. So 5 p.m. on Friday is our next show.
Where was she?
She's up with Jeff's family.
Where?
She's with Jeff's family.
With Jeff's family.
I thought she hated Jeff's friends.
They're so sweet. That's just Al being a jokester. All right. Good night, guys. We'll
Happy
see you
New
back.
Year.
See you on Friday.